Hello, East Chicago. This is Mayor Anthony Copeland, and I'm here to announce a new show that we will be bringing to you. It's called Message from the Mayor, where we will be filling you in on detailed accounts on projects that's going across our city and the concerns from viewers like yourself. Today, we thought we would just start off at the office and just show you how my day starts. Simple. This is the people's office. We're going to scan the office and let you see. You can see the clutter on my desk. I come in, day out. Messages will be piled here. I try to start my day the first half hour just answering calls that I missed the previous day. But one of the things that humble me the most is when I get cards or letters from viewers like yourself. Like, simply here, these are two cards that I received. One is from seniors. They just said, just wanted to let you know how much your thoughtfulness was appreciated. And then they all signed it. In those moments of when you're inundated with the bad news, then when one of these come across your desk, that is worth its weight in gold. Got one from the Lighthouse Academy where I went and visit one of the charter schools, and I saw the future, and our future is bright because I saw the young, energetic eyes of our children. But I'm going to ask Steve to just pan out and just give you a panoramic view of the office. It's a humble office. The furniture in this office have been here almost 35 years. It has spanned the Pastrick administration, the Pabea administration, the Copeland administration. We'll just do this shot, show you the office, and then from here we're going to take you to different areas in the city and try to show you some of the future projects that's up and coming. And not only that, in the next coming weeks, going to answer some of your calls. We're going to leave a telephone number where you can call and leave your concerns, and then we will follow them up. Hello, East Chicago. This is Mayor Copeland. I want to inform you of the projects that we'll be working on along the lakefront. Coupled with the RDA and East Chicago, we're looking to expand our lakefront. We're looking to beautify it. Our sister cities, Whiting and Porter, have gotten their share of the RDA money, and now East Chicago will be putting in for their big ask, they call it. And you simply envision what you want on your projects along the lakefront. They're called lakefront development. And then you put in for the dollars, and then you see what they're going to honor and allow you to have. Along our lakefront, the one problem that we have, we tend to be landlocked. When I first came in, I tried to open up a line of communication with Arcelor Middle, because next to us, Arcelor Middle probably owned the majority of the property that runs parallel to our beach or adjacent to our beach area. And I felt that if I could foster a new relationship with them and ask them to help us expand and enhance our beachfront, that we would have a beachfront bar none. The day will surely come when you will be able to go along the lake and go from Michigan City to Porter, to Gary, to East Chicago, to Whiting, on around to Hammond. That's part of that Marquette plan. That's part of the lakefront. Well into the 21st century plan. So when I looked across this, I simply say, how can we now expand our footprint at the lakefront? And simply looking at the maps, I saw something real simple. I saw that I didn't want to build condominiums along the lake. That would come out of a necessity. That would be a driving force that an outside developer would want to acquire land and do. I simply say, how can we capture more beach area? And looking at it, I saw where Inland, when in its heyday, when it had thousands upon thousands of workers, it had large tracts of parking lots. And I simply went to Arcelor Middle and asked them, can we use these for what they were traditionally used for, parking lots? We do not want to dig them up. We do not want to put foundations down. All we want to do is swap areas that we're using for parking along our lakefront and transfer that to their existing parking lots. And the ears perked up, and a wonderful thing happened. We're starting to enter into negotiations, and I hope that these negotiations will be fruitful. But I thought I would give you a sneak preview on what we can do along our lakefront. And the first thing is to acquire the land that we need. Traditionally, the city of East Chicago has this beach area here. If you ever go to the casino area, you will see that when you go to the casino's parking garage, directly behind it, this is also owned by the city of East Chicago. This area here where you see all of their cars, and when you go, you'll see a small section here that they allow the people from East Chicago park. But all of this area is parking for, it belongs to the city of East Chicago, but we have went into agreement to allow Ameristar to have their spillover parking, or i.e. for their employees to park along the rear here. And what we simply say we will do, we will go back and reclaim our parking area, which is here. And this will now allow us to probably increase this whole beach area by about 40%. This will now enter here, and all of this will become beach area. We will incorporate this with some green spaces along here, just a few parking areas along here, but that would open this up for the public to come in and enjoy. Also, it's what you call a 2-4. Now anyone who is visiting Ameristar's hotel can now come from here and visit our beach area. This will also profit them. So we're looking to take this traditional parking area and now move it on to Ameristar's property, and I will show you Ameristar's parking area. When you go north of Klein Avenue here, all of this parking belongs to Middle. All of this parking belongs to Middle. All of this parking area belongs to Middle. All of this area traditionally in here is Middle's. This area is Middle, and they use it for parking. In its heyday, these parking lots was filled with cars, where the steel area was booming and thousands upon thousands of people shared these lots. Now we're simply asking this. When you look at our footprint is reduced to this area, where when you come out to the marina, you will see all of the yachts and the boats parked along this area or stored along this area. Also, you will see the boats running along this area where they store them. Then when you go back here to the hotel area, you will see the hotel parking here and here. Then you will also see our water filtration plant as it exists now. This water filtration plant will be raised because we are, I would say, less than a year away from completion of our $52 million water filtration plant. This will allow us to raise this property here. Now the footprint will expand from here. All of this can now be developed. With Arsenal Middle's help, we will now relocate these yachts and boats into their traditional parking areas. We will move these yachts and boats to their traditional parking areas. We will now take the parking areas that was used for Ameristar, we will move those over to this area. This will free up all of this land now for potential development. All of this area that used to be the old water filtration plant, you will now look at this area being moved over here in Cars Park. You will almost look at this area almost doubling in size for potential growth. And this is what you can do when you foster a new relationship and when you have a good corporate partner like Ameristar and Middle Steel. We're looking forward to this. We pray every day that we will be successful in these negotiations, but we're simply asking them. We don't want to purchase the property. All we want to do is lease the property and transfer parking areas. If we are successful in this, this will give us a prized gem along the lakefront to where your family, my family, our families can now come out and enjoy a world-class beach area. And also anyone that's visiting Ameristar's hotel, they can brag and boast about the amenities that the hotel can give them. They can tell the people who are coming there to use their hotel, what, less than a quarter of a mile you can go from walking distance and walk, and then go from marble granite floors to your feet and toes being in the sand. So this is the potential that we have when we foster a new relationship with our corporate partners. You can see where it came to a complete stop. And the reason the project came to a complete stop, some people want you to believe that Copeland made the bridge come to a complete stop. But the reason the project came to a complete stop was Old Man Winter. Old Man Winter came out, he froze the ground, the workers could not work anymore. Then now Old Man Winter is giving way to the spring's first breath. And now you can see the workers are out there working. You can see the workers along the bridge are working because now the ground has given way, it's thawing. You can see the compactor over there because now they can compress the sand down, put the gravel down, compress it, and just put layer on top of layer. You can see the workers up there working in and out like they're going in and out of an anthill. And this project is on time. This project will be finishing up in August. Come either the first week or the midway through August, you will see the first traffic coming over this bridge. And this is a project that started originally in its inception in the Pastor administration. It lied dormant almost toward the end of the Pabea administration. This was a federal match program. I think it was an 80-20 match. And now you're looking at this project starting to come up. You can see the divide between the tracks where the train go through, and you can see the steep grade of the project. It will be a quick up, over, and back down, but it should alleviate a lot of the traffic flow that we have coming down Indianapolis. So we're looking for that. The project is on track, and it should be completed in August. In Chicago, we're now taking this tour to North Harbor. This is the first phase of the single family housing that will be going up. When I became mayor, the emphasis previously was on putting up rental housing. At the completion of phase one and two, they will be done put up 125 rental units. I simply asked them to just cease. And we will now move full steam ahead on single family housing. These are the first two units that will be going up. You're looking at another five units that will be going along in these vacant areas here. Then from here, we will make a full blown attempt to put up just single family housing only. Right now, the city of East Chicago is probably roughly 70-30. 70% of all of our housing stock being rental, 30% being a single family housing. We must change that tide. We must turn it around. We must instill community and a sense of pride and home ownership. That is the foundation of a city. That is the foundation of your tax base. And until we turn that the other side up, the city of East Chicago will find itself being totally dependent on sources like gaming to buffer this city. A healthy city has a mix of roughly 70, 30, 70 being single family housing, 30 being rental stock. And if you want to be in Utopia or the highest level you can accomplish, it's probably an 80-20, 80% being single family housing, 20% being rental. But again, the city of East Chicago will stem this tide of rental, and we will now start going back to making our emphasis on home ownership. We will buffer this up with incentives. The incentives that we will be offering is minimum $25,000 toward new home ownership, $50,000 in some cases. And in these, the incentives was as high as $100,000. So we're gonna do that along with adding this to the price of the house so that we can now start, how can you say, putting the incentives there, telling everybody East Chicago is the place to be. We're going to reward you for living in the city of East Chicago. And once we stabilize, our housing stock, you will see the growth of East Chicago double, triple. You will see our tax base becoming stable. You will see a healthy East Chicago. So we wanted to show you this is the first leg toward single family housing in the city of East Chicago in the North Harbor Project. But we will also do infill housing all across the city. We'll show you the efforts of redevelopment on where they're putting some up across the city. But the city of East Chicago will make a strong effort, a mighty push toward home ownership. We will reward the public safety employees for staying here in the city of East Chicago. We will reward all of the city workers with incentives to tell them, buy East Chicago, stay East Chicago, and watch East Chicago grow. We kind of show the people the project as it goes. East Chicago, thank you for tuning in. We will be bringing you future shows. You can email your questions, fax your questions, and we would pick up all your concerns and promptly get back with you with a response and time into future shows. Again, this is the beginning of informing you, empowering you with what is going on across your city, answering the concerns of the community. And again, Mayor Anthony Copeland would like to thank you for tuning in. Hello, East Chicago. This is Mayor Anthony Copeland. In the last few months, I have dealt with people from the community coming to talk to me about concerns in the schools. I've dealt with teachers. I have received letters from teachers. I have talked to the school board, its president and members, and I've also talked to the teachers union. A lot of these meetings was individuals coming expressing their concerns in the schools, and I simply took them on one at a time, and I listened to the concerns, and after a while, a picture started emerging that there should be a larger format to where we now include the public and bring everybody together so we can be on one accord and address the issues of the concerns that are going on in our school system. I also had maybe three meetings with Superintendent Harding. They were very productive meetings, just as it was with the teachers union, school board members, and also with the clergy. I have had many meetings with the clergy, and it simply sounded off an alarm bell that told me, bring everybody together. I think everybody is saying that they're concerned, but we are not on one accord to address how to solve the problems. And out of this have come this community forum that I would like to bring together and ask the public to come together and let all of the problem solvers sit there and hear the public's concern. Then when we feel these concerns, then we will be doing a follow-up meeting where we will be addressing those concerns with answers. Then we will do another follow-up meeting that will address permanent solutions. I'm hoping that when you can get the clergy to be part of this panel, when you can get the teachers union, when you can get school board members to sit up on stage, when you can get elected officials, when you can get parents and students, and all of them comprise a panel. And then you have the public tell them their concerns, and they become the sounding board, that we will have a resolution to these problems. I pray that when we come together as one mind of concerned citizens, parents, administrators, and elected officials, that we will be able to solve this. So I'm asking for your support. I'm asking that you attend the forum that we will be having on the 29th of this month at 6 p.m. at the Public Safety Building, or i.e. the police station. And we're asking each and every one of you that are concerned about making our school system better, about putting a conduit in place that will address these issues effectively, respectively, and promptly, that we will be able to move together as a community in one mind to solve the problems and to be able to put a system in place that will help our children into the 21st century and also improving our school system. So at this time, I will simply just send out the invite and hope that each and every one of you would attend. Thank you. Chicago. This is Mayor Anthony Copeland. In the last few months, I have dealt with people from the community coming to talk to me about concerns in the schools. I've dealt with teachers. I have received letters from teachers. I have talked to the school board, its president and members, and I've also talked to the teachers union. A lot of these meetings was individuals coming expressing their concerns in the schools, and I simply took them on one at a time, and I listened to the concerns, and after a while, a picture started emerging that there should be a larger format to where we now include the public and bring everybody together so we can be on one accord and address the issues of the concerns that are going on in our school system. I also had maybe three meetings with Superintendent Harding. They were very productive meetings, just as it was with the teachers union, school board members, and also with the clergy. I have had many meetings with the clergy, and it simply sounded off an alarm bell that told me, bring everybody together. I think everybody is saying that they are concerned, but we are not on one accord to address how to solve the problems. And out of this have come this community forum that I would like to bring together and ask the public to come together and let all of the problem solvers sit there and hear the public's concern. Then when we feel these concerns, then we will be doing a follow-up meeting where we will be addressing those concerns with answers. Then we will do another follow-up meeting that will address permanent solutions. I'm hoping that when you can get the clergy to be part of this panel, when you can get the teachers union, when you can get school board members to sit up on stage, when you can get elected officials, when you can get parents and students, and all of them comprise a panel. And then you have the public tell them their concerns, and they become the sounding board that we will have a resolution to these problems. I pray that when we come together as one mind of concerned citizens, parents, administrators, and elected officials, that we will be able to solve this. So I'm asking for your support. I'm asking that you attend the forum that we will be having on the 29th of this month at 6 p.m. at the Public Safety Building, or i.e. the police station. And we're asking each and every one of you that are concerned about making our school system better, about putting a conduit in place that will address these issues effectively, respectively, and promptly, that we will be able to move together as a community in one mind to solve the problems and to be able to put a system in place that will help our children into the 21st century and also improving our school system. So at this time, I will simply just send out the invite and hope that each and every one of you would attend.